Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to be discussing linear approximations and differentials. Let's start with an example of finding a linear approximation. So the question says to find the linearization of f of x equals cosine x at x equals pi over 3. Let's go ahead and work through this one solution. The formula for the linearization is L of x equals f of a plus f prime of a times x minus a. And this is the linearization of f at a. So in our particular problem, a is equal to this x that's given here. So a is pi over 3. And f of x is cosine x. So we're going to need the derivative, so that's pretty easy. So f prime of x, well, the derivative of cosine is negative sine. Okay, now we have everything for the formula, so we can plug it in. So we have L of x equals f of a, so f of pi over 3, plus f prime of pi over 3, times x minus pi over 3. By the way, if you're curious, this formula, this is basically the tangent line to the graph of the function at x equals a. So it's the same thing. So the tangent line is a linear approximation to the function. So L of x is equal to, so f of pi over 3 is just the cosine of pi over 3, plus, actually it's negative, but I'll leave it as plus negative sine of pi over 3, because that's f prime. F prime of x is negative sine x, so when we replace f prime of pi over 3, we just get negative sine of pi over 3 times x minus pi over 3. So L of x is equal to, so the cosine of pi over 3 is 1 half, just from memory, and then the sine of pi over 3 is the square root of 3 over 2. And then we just have x minus pi over 3. And so this is the linearization of f of x at x equals pi over 3. So basically, what this means is that, you write it in a different color up here, basically means that L of x is approximately equal to f of x when x is close to pi over 3. So when x is close to pi over 3, this is an approximation. This is also called the tangent line approximation. So kind of cool. It's also called the first order approximation. So it has three names: linearization, the tangent line approximation, and the first order linear approximation. All right, let's do a different type of problem. In this example, we are going to compute dy, which is called the differential, and delta y, given y equals x squared, x equals 1, and dx equals delta x equals 0.1. Let's go ahead and work through this problem solution. So dy is called the differential of y, and it's equal to f prime of x times dx. And what this does is it approximates the actual change in y. So the actual change in y is called delta y, and it's given by f of x plus delta x, and then you close the parentheses, and then minus f of x. So dy is the approximation of delta y, which is the actual change in y. You'll notice that these problems have f and f prime in them, but there's no f in the problem. That's because y is equal to f of x. In this particular case, since y equals x squared, we really have that f of x is equal to x squared. All right, let's go ahead and work out the answers. So dy is equal to, so since f of x is x squared, we can take the derivative using the power rule. You just bring down the 2 and subtract 1 from the exponent, so you get 2x. And then we have dx. So dy is equal to, so this is 2, x is 1, so you just plug it in. And then dx is 0.1, so you just plug it in. We end up with dy equal to 0.2. So that would be the approximation of the change in y. Let's compute delta y now. Delta y is equal to f of, so x is 1, delta x is 0.1. You close the parentheses, minus, and then f of 1. So delta y is equal to, you just have to be really careful when you plug in the numbers, just write the parentheses. And then you add the 1 and the 0.1, so you get 1.1 minus f of 1. Delta y is equal to, so f of 1.1, basically you just plug in 1.1 for x squared. We get 1.1 squared minus 1 squared. If you put this in your calculator, you will get 0.21. That's pretty cool, right? The actual change in y is 0.21, and the approximation is 0.2. So it's a pretty good approximation in this case. Let's finish up by doing something a little bit different. In this last example, we are going to find the differential of some functions. So part A, we have y equals the secant of 2 theta. Let's go ahead and find the differential solution. So this is just basically another way of writing derivatives. So instead of writing y prime or dy dx, we just write dy. And then we take the derivative of secant of 2 theta with respect to theta. So the derivative of secant is secant tangent. Except in this case, we have a 2 theta on the inside. We have to use the chain rule. We take the derivative of the outside, which is secant tangent, and we leave it evaluated at the inside. We get secant 2 theta, tangent 2 theta, and then times the derivative of the inside. The derivative of 2 theta is 2, and then we put it d theta. Again, just differentiating with the chain rule, we take the derivative of the outside, which is secant tangent, we leave it evaluated at the inside, and then we multiply by the derivative of the inside, which is 2. And the d theta just goes there at the end. It's just shorthand notation for differentiation. So dy is equal to, now we can put the 2 in the front, we get 2 secant 2 theta tangent 2 theta d theta. This would be the differential of y. So it's just another way to write derivatives. This is very useful when we do integration. So just a very useful notation to have handy. Let's do one more example. Part B, y equals x times e to the x. Let's work through its solution. This time we have a product. We have x times e to the x. We're going to use the product rule. Recall the product rule says if you have f times g, and you take the derivative, you can think of f as your first function and g as your second. So it's the derivative of the first times the second plus the first times the derivative of the second. So in this case, dy, x is our first function, so it's the derivative of x, which is 1, times the second, which is e to the x, plus the first, which is x, times the derivative of the second, and the derivative of e to the x is e to the x. Then you have to put a parentheses and a dx. Writing it one more time, we end up with dy equals parentheses e to the x plus x e to the x dx. And that would be the differential of dy. So this is just shorthand for differentiating, and it's used a lot in integration. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. I hope it's been helpful. Good luck.